Welcome back. In the last lesson, I showed you how to send emails out from NetSuite. But what do you do if you've received an email on your, let's say, your Outlook email, and now that email is not logged in NetSuite? Let's say it's an email from a customer. You don't actually have that logged to that customer in NetSuite. Or for example, let's say you or a salesman has a lot of interaction back and forth with one or more customers or leads, and now none of those emails are being recorded to those interactions and those entities in NetSuite. How do you solve that? Well, SuperSync has an app called SuperSync Email for Outlook that resolves that problem. So in this lesson, I'm going to be showing you how that works. So let's take a look. All right, so here we are in Outlook, and we're on the web browser version right now, but the same applies. SuperSync also works for the desktop and the mobile version of Outlook. And one thing I want to point out is I'm not going to be showing you how this gets set up. We already have SuperSync set up for this Outlook, so I'm going to be showing you how the functionality works. So here we are in our Outlook, and we see we've got this email from a customer, Brooks Flanagan, so we can click on that. And so we've got this email, and it also has this attachment. So we want to log this email connected to this customer, Brooks Flanagan Distribution, who's a customer in NetSuite. We want to log that to that customer in NetSuite. So we're going to go to the right here and click on More Actions. And notice down here, it's got this little option, Email for NetSuite. So we're going to click on that. And it pulls up this little thing on the side. And it automatically pulls in that name and does a search in NetSuite. So we see immediately this contact pulls up, as well as a customer. There's also an employee. It pulls up any record that has Brooks Flanagan associated with it, either that name or in this case, the email that we received it from. So all of these different records show up. So we wanna log. So we're gonna click on that little box there, and then we can go over to log email. And now it's logged. And one option you have here, you actually have this little button here. And if you click that, it actually opens up NetSuite for you and it will bring you exactly to that record. So it was the contact, Brooks Flanagan Distribution. So it pulled up that record exactly. We logged down. And if you go to communications subtab and we're on messages in the sublist, we immediately see that this record was logged. We see who it came from, who it went to, the subject. We also see there was an attachment. We can open up that attachment. So it automatically appears here. So let's go back to that Outlook. So we now have that as logged. And notice here it has this green log to NetSuite. So you do know it's kind of verified for you that it's been logged. And you can also, when you're looking back in your emails, you know which ones have been appropriately logged and not. So one additional thing you can do here, notice this auto log conversation. If we click that on, what that's doing is now this email thread, if there's any future back and forth, let's say you respond to their email, Brooks Flanagan responds back to you, all of the back and forth will be continuously logged to NetSuite for this thread. So not necessarily from the contact, but on this specific chain of emails, everything will get logged to NetSuite. All right, so that's how that works. Now, let's say you have an additional record, maybe it's another customer or contact that's associated with, let's say this is a sale that you're trying to cultivate, but there's another record that's associated. So what you can do is you can actually do a search. So let's say chess. Okay, so the chess art gallery, which is another customer we have, is related to the sale in some way. So we want to make sure that this email also gets logged to that customer. So we can simply do a search. It pulls up everything related to that other customer, and you can simply click on this and hit log email. And now it shows that it has as well been logged to the gallery. And again, you can do the auto log conversation, etc. And as before, if you click this link here, it pulls up that record. So we can see this customer that we're searching. So if you have any question, you know, is this the right one? You can just go straight to it and you go, yep, that's the right address. I know that's the right customer. So going back to this. So I've shown you now how to take an email that you've had incoming and have that logged. But what if you're trying to originate an email out? Well, in that case, let's say we go to new mail. and we want to send it to joe@jones.com. So we can go to, now it's up here. If you click these three dots and you hit email for NetSuite, it's going to give this BCC. It's going to pop up right here showing that that email is now going to be, as you send that email out, it's going to automatically log it to NetSuite. So that's how it works on the outbound side of things. So one additional thing I want to show you is, what if you receive an email? So we're going to pull this up again. And by the way, this window, if you want to leave it up, you can always click on the pin up here. That will log that window, so it just kind of stays attached right there. And let's say you receive an email from someone and it's not a customer or a contact that's already logged in NetSuite. It's a completely, maybe a new lead, etc. So what do you do if you don't have an existing resource to go to? Well, you can go down here and you have this new record option. So let's click on that. And you see it gives us all these options and you can customize it. So if you don't want to have all these options, if there's only a few that you'll ever use, when you do the setup process for SuperSync, you can kind of pare it down to exactly what you need. But you can basically set up whether it's a partner, a lead, a customer, all of these different things. You can specify, let's say in this case, it's a new customer, so not in NetSuite, but we want to generate that record in this process. We'll click on that. And it asks us for the basic key information, you know, what's the subsidiary it's related to, what currency are you dealing with, what's the name, the status, what's the email address you're dealing with. Obviously, in this case, it would be the email address you received for. And when you put in this information and hit submit, it actually pushes that information to NetSuite and it generates that record and that entity, in this case, a customer, in NetSuite. So one thing that's great about this SuperSync email for Outlook is the fact that it doesn't require a NetSuite license to operate it. So for example, let's say your company has 50 sales representatives and you don't necessarily want to have 50 different licenses for all these sales reps. You don't have to give them all these access. They do need access all to the SuperSync email for Outlook, but they don't all need a NetSuite license. So you give them access to SuperSync. So it can be a great way to limit the number of NetSuite licenses you have while still giving the necessary employees, whether it's sales representatives or anyone else, the access and the ability to create these records in NetSuite and log these emails to the appropriate records. One additional thing I want to talk about is the fact that, so this is SuperSync email for Outlook. There's also a SuperSync app called MailSync, and that has similar functionality. However, what I've shown you so far, this has all been manual, right? You're taking an email, logging it. MailSync, it requires a little bit more setup in the beginning, a little bit more to get it implemented, but you set parameters in terms of what emails coming in fit the mold, and then those emails are just automatically logged in NetSuite. There's no manual actions necessary. So once it gets set up, for example, you might limit any intercompany emails, but any new emails coming in from like people that would be customers just automatically get logged through MailSync to the appropriate NetSuite records, or even generating the NetSuite records that are necessary. So that's MailSync. And for certain companies, that's more helpful to just have that automation. And that's how you use SuperSync email for Outlook. I'll see you in the next video.